40 years ago, Al Michaels put a bow on one of the biggest upsets in sports history with six now iconic words.
You believe in miracles? Yes!
You may know the basics, but not the whole story. So here are nine things you may not know about the Miracle on Ice in 90 seconds. Start the clock. This game was actually shown on tape delay in the States. ABC tried giving the IIHF $125,000 to move the faceoff from 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. But they couldn't get the Russians to agree. 32.4 million people still watched a game that was already done. This was not a gold medal game. In fact, it wasn't even a semi-final. Back then, the medal round was a round robin. The Russians hammered Sweden in their next game, and if the Americans had lost to Finland, well, the Soviets would have won the gold medal. The night before the big game, American goaltender Jim Craig and Soviet forward Sergei Makarov bonded in the athletes' village over a game of centipede. The Soviets dominated the Americans in the second period, outshooting them 12-2. Now, Hall of Famer Ken Dryden was the color man, and the day before the game, Dryden had a car service drive him up to Toronto, where he took the Canadian bar exam. He passed and came right back to Lake Placid to call the game. Nowadays, celebrities fill the stands at hockey games, but for this game, the only celebrity was Jamie Farr, who played Klinger on MASH. Now, most hockey fans have seen the movie Miracle, which is awesome, by the way. But did you know there was a 1981 made-for-TV movie called Miracle on Ice featuring Steve Guttenberg?
Craig, Jim.
Look in the camera, Jim. Next.
Just how hard was Herb Brooks on the U.S. players? Well, Michael Ruzzioni said this at his funeral. Quote, "Here I am, 48 years old, and whenever Herb called the house, I was afraid I'd done something wrong." And finally, when Sports Illustrated asked their readers to vote on their most iconic cover ever, yeah, this was the winner.